In this lecture, we will discuss about the cycloconverter. So let us first define what is the cycloconverter. A device which converts input power at one frequency to output power at different frequency with one stage conversion is called cycloconverter. Now this cycloconverter can be defined in two types, that is step up cycloconverter and step down cycloconverter. So what is step up cycloconverter? The cycloconverter in which output frequency is more than the input frequency, so that is called the step up cycloconverter. And if output frequency is less than the input frequency, then we call it step down cycloconverter. This cycloconverter further can be classified as single phase to single phase cycloconverter, three phase to single phase cycloconverter, and three phase to three phase cycloconverter. Now these cycloconverters can be classified according to type of connection. What is type of connection? That is, first one is midpoint type cycloconverter, and second is bridge type of cycloconverter. These type of cycloconverters we will discuss further. So let us say first discuss the midpoint type of cycloconverter. So why it is called the midpoint type of cycloconverter? Because as see from the diagram, that low resistance R, that is the midpoint, or this low resistance R is connected at the midpoint or center of the secondary of the transformer. That's why we call it is a midpoint type of cycloconverter. Now let us look the arrangement of this cycloconverter. We have a four thyristors here. What are the thyristors? Thyristor P1, N1 and P2, N2. Thyristor P1 and N1, they are connected in NT parallel. Similarly, thyristor P2 and N2, they are also connected in NT parallel. In this group of thyristors, thyristor P1 and P2, they are called as a positive group thyristor or positive envelope thyristor. And thyristor N1 and N2, they are called the negative group thyristor or negative envelope thyristors. Now we have a source of supply, that is Vs. Then we have a primary of the transformer. Then we have a secondary of the transformer. And the arrangement of the connection has been shown as we have drawn this figure. Similarly, we have drawn here the output waveforms of the cycloconverter. That according to the operation of this thyristor, how we will receive this waveform, that we will discuss in the next steps. So let us see, first discuss about that if we have a source of supply, this point is positive and this point is as a negative, then what will have a operation? This about the cycloconverter. That is, if this is positive, the secondary of this side will be a positive, and at the bottom secondary of this side will have a negative. It means this will have a positive and this will have a negative, and we have a midpoint connection here. So this point will be negative. It means this positive point will have a more positive with respect to this point, and here this point will have a more positive polarity compared to this point. So this is how, once we have supply voltage this positive and this negative, we will have a polarity like this: this positive, negative, and positive and negative. Now we'll see, once we'll have a negative cycle. So negative half cycle will have a reverse polarity. It means we'll have a this side positive and this side negative. It means bottom side at this point will have a positive polarity, at this midpoint connection will have negative polarity. Further, this point will have a positive polarity and this point will have a negative polarity. So what we can say is, this point is more positive compared to this point, and this point is more positive compared to this point. That is how the polarity will be defined for the operation of this cycloconverter. Now, let us describe the operation of the cycloconverter. Now, this operation depends upon that we have designed the circuit to give the output frequency more than the input frequency, because we are going to discuss about the single phase to single phase step up cycloconverter and which have a midpoint type connection. So we have designed to find out the output frequency, that is f out equals to 4 times the input frequency. What is the input frequency? We have taken an input cycle as a 1 cycle only, and we will receive in output 4 cycles. That's why we are getting at f output is equals to 4 times the input frequency. So how this circuit will be described? Let us see. Once this is a positive and this is a negative, and thyristor P1 will be forward bias. So we will apply a positive trigger pulse to thyristor P1. So once a positive trigger pulse is applied to thyristor P1, it means current from this positive will flow to and through the thyristor P1, and it will come back here and goes towards the point B. Through the resistance R, it will complete the negative. It means by conduction of the thyristor P1, what voltage we have received? Starting from 0, we have received this voltage in respect of the input supply voltage. Now, at an angle of omega T1, this is the point omega T1, we will switch off the thyristor P1 by force commutation, and we will apply a trigger pulse to thyristor N2. So once we supply a trigger pulse to thyristor N2, then how the circuit will complete? Supply from here, this positive will flow from here, from A to B, and it will come here to the thyristor N2 and goes back towards the negative. It means in this case, current direction is reverse. Current is flowing from A to B. However, in previous case, this current was flowing from B to A. So once current is flowing from A to B, how the circuit is traced? It means from omega T1 to omega T2, this negative output voltage will receive. So from here, it will come negative voltage and till the angle of omega T2. So at an angle omega T2, we will switch off the thyristor N2, will switch off the thyristor N2 by force commutation. And again, we will apply a positive trigger pulse to thyristor P1. Once we supply a positive trigger pulse to thyristor P1, then again, how the current will be traced? From this positive, current will flow to thyristor P1. It will come here and goes towards the point B, and this current will flow from B to A through resistance R and goes back to negative. So how the waveform will be traced? At an angle of omega T2, this will get the positive polarity of output voltage, and this will complete this cycle. Now, at an angle of omega T3, we will switch off the thyristor P1 by force commutation, and we will supply a trigger pulse to thyristor N2. This operation I am discussing about the positive half cycle only. So once we supply a trigger pulse to thyristor N2, then a current will flow from this positive to point A, and from A to B, then it will come to this thyristor N2 and it will flow toward the negative. It means we have completed in a negative half cycle, that is from omega T3 to omega T4. Supply polarity we have received like this. So we have reached at the point omega T4. It means in the supply voltage, once we have applied the supply voltage of half of the positive cycle from 0 to pi here at the transformer input, then we have received two cycles of the output voltage, that is one cycle like this and another cycle like this. Now we'll be tracing the operation when the input supply is having a negative supply voltage. So once we have negative supply voltage here, so this side will be the positive and this side will be the negative. Similarly, across the secondary of the output, we have this positive and this point will have negative. Similarly, this point will have positive and this point will have a negative polarity. So again, we can compare that this point will have more positive compared to this point and this point will have more positive value polarity compared to this point. So by seeing these polarity operations, we want to describe the operation of this cyclochronometer for the negative half cycle. So how will describe? Let us first provide a, since this is positive, so provide a trigger pulse to thyristor P2. So once we supply a trigger pulse to thyristor P2, the supply current from this positive will flow through the thyristor P2 and will come here and will go towards the point B, and from B to A through resistance R, it will come with the negative. So how the current is traced here? It means at an angle of omega T4, voltage polarity will be traced like this and it will come here to the point of omega T5. So at point omega T5, we will switch off the thyristor P2 by force commutation and will supply a trigger pulse to thyristor N1. So once we supply a trigger pulse to thyristor N1, then a positive polarity will drive a current flow from this point to point A and between from A to point B through resistance R, and it will come back through here and it will complete through N1 to the negative. So what will happen? We see here, once we have triggered N1, then supply was with negative polarity we have received. So negative will be, polarity will be traced like this. So finally we have reached at an angle of omega T6. Now at an angle of omega T6, we will again switch off the thyristor N1 by force commutation and will apply a positive trigger pulse to thyristor P2. So once again, for this negative half cycle, once you supply a trigger pulse to thyristor P2, the current will flow from this positive to this side and will come here, it will go towards the point B, and through resistance it will complete this negative. So again we have completed a positive polarity voltage from this omega T6 to this value and comes down at the omega T7. Now at omega T7, we will switch off the thyristor P2 by force commutation and finally we'll apply a trigger pulse to thyristor N1. So once we supply a trigger pulse to thyristor N1, then from this positive polarity, current will flow from A to B through this and it will come here to N1, and from N1 it will complete the negative of this point. So cycle is completed. How it is traced here? It will be traced here from omega T7, we will get the negative output voltage and it will come here to until the angle of omega T8. It means we have completed the cycle. So what we see here, that for the first half wave cycle, we have received the two cycles. That is, starting from zero, we have received one cycle like this up to the point of omega T2, and second cycle like this up to the point of omega T4. Now for the negative half cycle, we have received one cycle from omega t4 to this, like this, and up to the omega t6. Now again, from omega t6, we have received one more cycle, that is starting from here omega t6 to this point and omega t8. So what we see here that for a positive half cycle, we have received two cycles, and for the negative half cycle also, we have received again two cycles. It means the output frequency of the cycloconverter is four times the input frequency. This is what we wanted to describe, the operation of single phase to single phase step up cycloconverter by having this midpoint type of configuration. So if you like this video, please subscribe this channel to receive the next updated video regarding the cycloconverter.